The destroyer has returned.
I am the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God.
Great light reappears, redly in the skies. The destroyer has returned.
I am the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God. And the Lord said, I have surely seen the affliction of my people which are in Egypt, and have heard their cry by reason of their taskmasters. For I know their sorrows, and I am come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians, and to bring them up out of that land unto a good land and a large, unto a land flowing with milk and honey.
When blood drops upon the earth, the destroyer will appear. The mountains will open up and belch forth fire and ash. Trees will be destroyed, and all living things engulfed.
Go down, Moses!
The biblical story of the Exodus that everyone knows tells the tale of Moses when leading the slaves from Egypt to the Promised Land became trapped at the Red Sea. In an act of divine intervention, God parted the waves as the Israelites fled to safety. This text comes from a collection of surviving manuscripts from the burning of Glastonbury Abbey.
Also called the Destroyer, in the Colbran, which is an ancient gospel found in Scotland that was omitted from biblical text, much like the Dead Sea Scrolls were. It reads, Men forgot the days of the Destroyer. Only the wise know where it went, and that it shall return at the appointed time. The Destroyer, its color, bright and fierce and ever-changing, was an unstable appearance, a fierce body of flames. Though stating Nibiru usually passes without causing harm, the tablets describe one cataclysmic event which occurred when Nibiru neared Earth. It says, first, black spots appeared on the sun's surface.
Good morning, friends. It's foggy morning here in my city. So today while I was traveling, I found a lot of fog and my mind clicked to see the sun under the fog. So with my camera I zoomed it and I happened to find there are the three black spots are present on the sun.
The Earth's magnetic field became weaker.
Skywatch Media News for July the 12th, 2021. The magnetic field that protects our planet has been weakening across wide stretches of area from Africa to South America, and the phenomenon has yet to be fully understood. The decline in the protective shield gives rise to the speculation that Earth is on the verge of an imminent pole shift.
The temperature rose and ice caps began melting. This event we call the deluge, or the Great Flood.
Scientists in Siberia have confirmed the highest ever recorded temperature in the Arctic. That's 38 degrees Celsius or 100 degrees Fahrenheit. And the United Nations says it's a massive alarm bell in the climate crisis.
Welcome to the Pole of Cold. Verkhoyansk in Russia is supposed to be one of the coldest inhabited places on Earth. But last summer, as these images show, it set a different record. 38 degrees Celsius, the highest temperature ever measured in the Arctic.
The heat that we saw in Siberia in 2020 would have been almost impossible without climate change. The Arctic, as WMO keeps saying, is one of the fastest warming parts of the world. It's warming more than twice as fast as the global average.
And with the heat came the drought. Even the waterlogged vastness of Siberia burned. This year, according to NASA, smoke from the Siberian wildfires reached the North Pole for the first time in recorded history. And every acre that burns releases more greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. But that wasn't the only alarming temperature record announced by the UN. This one was recorded on the other side of the globe.
Last year also, there was a new temperature record in the Antarctic continent of 18.3 degrees Celsius. That was recorded at an Argentinian base called Esperanza.
And that's not all that's happening in Antarctica. Scientists monitoring the Thwaites Glacier, which is the size of Great Britain, say it's melting so fast that it's dumping 50 billion tons of ice into the ocean each year. The dramatic acceleration of this melting will lead to the glacier's rapid retreat and could cause its eventual collapse.
It also reads, for days before the day of the deluge, the earth was rumbling, groaning, as if with pain.
If you can hear this, hopefully you can. I hear this from time to time, but never see a plane. Not that this is the best view of the sky, but you can trust me, I heard it enough times. Yesterday morning about 9:20, 9 a.m. today.
Believers in general, or what is normally referred to as the Christian church. Because the church cannot point to a time when they were in bondage in Egypt or anywhere else for that matter. Now, I also want to look at this word ensign. He said he would set up an ensign for the nations. We want to make sure that we understand what this word means, because we don't want to overlook its significance.
Let my people go!
Egypt land.
Let my people go.
Oppressed so hard they could not stand.
Let my people go.
So the Lord said, go down.
Go down.
Moses.
Moses.
Way down,
down
in Egypt land. Tell old Pharaoh to let my people go.
Let